I'm Alexa.
And I'm Rory. And together we are...
The Romies!
We are married.
To each other.
Yeah. And we are a touring musical duo.
Our music has taken us to all kinds of places and keeps us always on the go.
So we know if you're listening that travel is, or you want it to be, a regular part of your life.
Or you're just super busy and trying to keep your head on straight.
Thanks.
None of my plans are going according to plan.
So today's podcast is sponsored by the Lake Charles Southwest Louisiana Convention and Visitors Bureau. Woo-hoo. And you can find them at...
visitlakecharles.org.
And follow on...
#visitlakecharles.
Woohoo! All right. Yeah. So in honor of today's sponsor, and because Rory is from Lake Charles,
yes,
we want to hopefully encourage you to visit Rory's hometown and give you some local insights.
Because that's what we like.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
We love scenery and cities when we travel, but we find it's even more fun when we can connect with someone local and find out what they love to do and see. So, Rory, you just happen to be the local in this case.
That's right. I'm actually from Moss Bluff, an unincorporated town across the river from Lake Charles. I grew up there. Lake Charles is my stomping ground. There, the area.
So we're going to dive in and tell you a little bit about Rory's favorite places to see and things to do in Southwest Louisiana.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so Rory, tell us just a little bit generally what you love about Southwest Louisiana, and then we'll dial in into some specifics that you recommend for people to do and see and visit.
Yeah, well, in Southwest Louisiana, we've got a really deep culture and deep heritage that we all are very proud of. You know, the license plate also says Sportsman's Paradise, and really it is. I mean, if you like outdoor things to do, it is an amazing place to go. What a great place to grow up to. Family is really important to everyone around.
That's great.
Oh my goodness, food is amazing. I think it's probably the best food in the world. I might be a little partial, but I'm just saying. It's hard for me to eat seafood anywhere else in the world because I've been so spoiled with good Cajun cooking.
Well, awesome.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so tell us a little bit about when you were a kid.
All right, so I grew up in Moss Bluff, and we were less than a mile from the river, so my brother and I used to always walk down to the Calcasieu River, and we'd go fishing off the bank and stuff, and as we got older, you know, we'd go water skiing on the river and things like this and that. But there are so many things that I love to do and that we did growing up that I still, when I go home, I love to do them, so I think what'll be cool is to go through some of those.
All right.
All right, so when I was a kid growing up, I loved it when we would go to the old family station wagon or later the LTD or whatever the giant boat car was at the time.
Well, you do have a ginormous family,
I must say.
Rory is one of five kids. He's youngest one.
I'm the baby of the family.
And we already have like 5,000 nieces and nephews because it's just such a huge family. So, yes, they needed whatever big car they could find.
Whatever large vehicle that would transport everyone, because we'd also load it up with rods and reels, tackle, stringer, dip net, sometimes a cast net if we wanted to catch some shrimp, an ice chest with drinks and sandwich bacons for lunch, my mom, dad, my brothers, my sister, me, and always some string and a pack of chicken necks.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, it was on.
Chicken necks.
Yeah, I'll get to that in a minute. Yeah, those of you who aren't from Southwest Louisiana may not know what the chicken necks are for, but we'll hear about that. So, all right, we'd load up the car and we would head south down Highway 14. We'd go past Boone's Corner to Highway 27 and keep on heading south into the Cameron Prairie National Wildlife Refuge. I think that little drive is officially called the Creole Nature Trail.
Cool.
Now, so if you're in Southwest Louisiana visiting there, you should drive the Creole Nature Trail down south into the refuge. It's amazing. That's one thing about Southwest Louisiana. We have loads of wildlife refuges. We've got the Cameron Prairie National Wildlife Refuge, the Sabine National Wildlife Refuge, Rockefeller Wildlife Refuge, and the Lacassine National Wildlife Refuge. So if you're an outdoor person and you like to see amazing things in nature, Southwest Louisiana is an awesome place to go.
Nice.
All right. So we head south and we go down to the Cameron Prairie.
Okay.
And all right. So once you get down past Boone's Corner and start heading south, just before you get into the prairie, the Creole Canal starts running alongside the road. So we would drive on down and we'd find a place we wanted to stop on the canal. By the way, it's really cool as you're driving down that road to be looking for alligators, see how many alligators you can count, and all kind of reptiles and crazy big birds and stuff, and nutrirats. Oh, yeah, nutrirats.
Nutri?
Nutria.
Nutria.
Yeah, we call them Nutri-rats. Rat should give you a clue as to kind of what it's like.
And you try to count these critters.
Well, no. I mean, you just, you're looking for them, right? It was fun to count how many alligators you see because there's a lot of alligators down there. Yeah. So you got to, you know.
Well, you're still alive, so I guess it turns out okay.
Yeah, it turns out okay. But, you know, so you drive along the canal and you find a place you want to stop, and we'd stop. We'd take all the stuff out of the car. We'd fish. And if the fish weren't biting, we might take the cast net and throw it and try and catch some shrimp. Now, when all else fails, either because, you know, the fish weren't biting or maybe we wanted some crab for dinner, here's where the chicken necks come in. You take that string you brought, right? It could be something as simple as a kite string. You tie a chicken neck to the end of it, and you throw it out in the canal.
And chicken necks are just hanging around. Like, you can find these? Like, you can just buy chicken necks?
Everybody knows this, yes, okay. Of course. Chicken necks, come on.
All right.
Well, you go to your Uncle Jim's house and you cut a chicken's head off and get you some fresh necks.
So sweet.
I'm just saying, yeah. So you tie the chicken neck to a string, you throw it out in the canal, and then you wait, and you'll feel the string starting to shake a little bit, and it'll get kind of tight, and you pull it really slowly up towards the bank, and then you can see these big old crabs hanging on and trying to eat your chicken neck. And that's when your brother or somebody, you know, close by, takes the dip net and catches the crabs. You catch it in the dip net and you put it in your ice chest. Now, the thing you got to be careful is that happened.
Dip net is, but
that,
okay.
That happened all the time. Yeah, it's really cool. That happened all the time is alligators. They also like chicken necks.
Oh.
So, yeah, you want a string to be long enough that there's alligators nearby that if they take your chicken neck, you can get it back without getting too awful
close. Well, I definitely want my chicken neck back.
You want your chicken neck back because you're trying to catch crabs.
Okay.
Yeah. So it was really cool because the area that we usually go to was down near what we always called the Creole Nature Trail, which is a footpath, basically, a shell footpath that would go out into the marsh, right, into this Cameron Prairie.
Mm-hmm.
It'd go about a mile, and at the end of it is a wooden, raised wooden platform that you could climb up on and see for miles around.
Mm. All kind of, that's cool.
Oh, it's really awesome. I think, personally, the marsh and the swamps are beautiful. And so to be able to walk through that and see everything is just amazing. You got to be careful of snakes, cottonmouths. They're all over the place down there. Alligators are all over the place. As a matter of fact, it was not uncommon that as we'd walk down the path, there would be an alligator covering the path. He's out there sunning, right? But we wanted to keep going, so we'd pick up rocks and throw at the alligator to try to get him to move. And it worked. I mean,
okay,
interestingly.
Well, you are still alive. I'll just point out, you are still alive.
Yeah.
I'm
not so sure I'd do that now.
Okay.
For those of you who don't know, alligators are incredibly fast. If you've ever seen a lizard run across the ground, imagine that, like, you know, 100 times bigger, weighing, you know, anywhere from 500 to, I don't know, they could get really big, right? And they can, but just...
They eat a lot of that.
They can outrun
cooking,
a horse in a short sprint. So,
wow.
Yeah, it's hard to get
so
away
you,
from them.
So you might want to study Alligator Safety 101 before visiting Lake Charles.
I love it down there. We'd also take trips down to Holly Beach. So if you keep heading south down the road I was talking about, you go down to Holly Beach, and it's like any other beach, right? So we'd go down, we'd swim, we'd build sandcastles, look for shells, and then we'd also go seining. We'd take a seine net with us.
A seine net.
Yeah, a seine net.
And what is this?
S-E-I-N-E. You take a net, and one of you stands, I don't know, knee-deep or something like that, or waist-deep in the water, and the other one takes the other end of the net and walks out deeper into the water and makes a big sweep, right? So the one person stays where they are in the shallow water, another one makes a big sweep, and you catch whatever gets into the net. Hmm. It's really cool.
Could
you catch stingrays, all kind of crazy fish and stuff? It's a lot of fun. And you don't kill the stuff mostly. You just put it back, right?
Well, that's sweet. I prefer
that. Yeah, except
that.
For the jellyfish. I leave them on shore to die or for someone to step on.
You're so sweet, Rory.
I'm just saying.
All right. Any other things before we wrap it up here?
Absolutely, yes. The Lacassine National Wildlife Refuge. If you like fishing for bigmouth bass or white perch, what we call them, white perch, crappie, sunfish, catfish. Man, Lacassine National Wildlife Refuge is an amazing place to go and fish. And of course, you know, from November up until into March for migratory birds, there's a little area down there called Pintail Drive that you could, it's a circle drive you can go around, and there are tens of thousands of migratory birds from geese to ducks to all kind of stuff. It's like watching Wild Kingdom. Wait, what's it called? Wild Kingdom?
Sure.
It's
National
like,
Geographic.
it's like watching National Geographic. I mean, it's really cool. So if you're a bird watcher, that is an amazing place to go. Also, grew up playing golf, right? Mm-hmm. So in Southwest Louisiana, we've got really nice municipal courses.
Let us know a little bit about your favorite restaurants to visit.
Jambalaya, crawfish, pie, and a filet gumbo. Ah, my restaurants. Yes, I do have my favorites. There is one where I get my favorite boudin. If you've never had boudin, B-O-U-D-I-N, boudin is God's food to man. Especially smoked boudin, right? So Hackett's, the best boudin. In my opinion, their smoked and smoked spicy is off the charts. Really good. Also, their lunch plates are huge and really good. Great homemade food at Hackett's.
Nice.
Also.
And then, of course, your mom is home cooking, but
not everybody can come to your house. It's hard to eat out when somebody cooks like my mama does because you just want to eat at home.
Yeah,
That's right. There's Prony's Deli, the American bread, get some great sandwiches, including muffalettas. Cotton's Hamburgers for a great egg burger. Oh, my goodness, they're really inexpensive and so good. They're onion rings. Steamboat Bill's for great local seafood. Steamboat Bill's has some really good food. Also, Tony's Pizza. It's kind of a Lake Charles landmark now, you know?
Now, being the vegetarian that I am,
yes,
I love Tony's Pizza. They have a whole wheat crust.
They do.
So I love that. And you can put broccoli and spinach on your pizza.
Why would you do that to a pizza.
Sometimes you need your vegetables.
Yeah, why would you do that to a pizza? You got Tony's Pizza,
good.
Okay, for the good pizzas, not the ones she's talking. No, they're great. Okay. And downtown Lake Charles now, they've redone the downtown area, so you can take a walk down there and hear some great music, really good food, great places to hang out. So I would encourage you, if you haven't been to Southwest Louisiana, it's an amazing place to go if you love outdoor life. Very, very friendly culture. You need to go. It's where I'm from. You know what I'm saying? It's where I'm going.
We hope we've inspired you to come see for yourself all the interesting things Southwest Louisiana has to offer. Make plans now to come visit and experience Southwest Louisiana in your own way, because chicken necks are optional. Thanks for writing in, y'all. Let us know your other questions. We look forward to answering them on future podcasts. Let us know what you want to hear. Keep in touch with us.
Yep. Thanks for listening.
And thank you again to the Lake Charles Southwest Louisiana Convention and Visitors Bureau. You can find them at www.visitlakecharles.org. And keep an eye out for our blog post that you'll see there pretty soon here, www.visitlakecharles.org/blog. And catch our latest adventures and music at www.theromies.com. And we have a new website, don't we, Rory?
Ah, do we now?
Yes. So it's worth checking out. And you can hear our music also, not only on the website, but also on Spotify, Amazon, and iTunes, as well as our other podcast episodes.
And what website would that be?
www.theromies.com.
All right.
Follow us on Instagram and Facebook at
The Romies.
Very good. And that is T
H E R O A
M
I
E
S.
All right. See y'all next time.
Bye.